Welcome and season's greetings. This is Mark Murphy from BBC Radio Suffolk. Oh, yes, it is. I said, oh, yes, it is. Enough of all of that. I'm delighted to welcome you to Henley Community Centre for their fifth and biggest pantomime ever. This year, it's Snow White and Dwarf Club 7. Yes, that's right. Snow White and Dwarf Club 7. Let's get the boring stuff out of the way first, shall we? Please make sure your mobiles are switched off, or at least on silent. And remember, smoking is only available outside the main porch entrance near the car park. Because of our child protection policy and copyright, please do not take photos or any video recordings during the show. Our main fire exits are situated to your left and the rear of the main hall, and the assembly point is the main football pitch. We also do have strobe lighting during the performance, so be warned. The bar will be open during the interval and pre-ordered drinks will be waiting for your collection. The bar will stay open after the performance, so please stay and chat to the cast and friends. Ice cream and candy floss will be available in the main hall at the rear at the interval. Our pantomime needs a lot of audience participation, so we want lots of booing. We want lots of hissing. We want lots of it's behind you and oh no it isn't. You can do that, can't you? I said you can do that, can't you? Finally, can I thank the cast, the backstage crew, musicians, the Players Committee and Henley Community Centre Charity, of whom this production would not have been possible without them. Thank you all for your support, so let's sit back and enjoy the show. Ladies and gentlemen, let the magic begin.
Snow White. She got her name because she was as pure as snow. Despite all the joy in the land, king was a widower. One day, a strange woman arrived bearing a basket of fruit to the king. 2 days later, good King White's found dead. Whole county's in mourning. Before he passed away, Spadeball Gardener Douglas Fir promised to look after the princess, Snow White, and keep her safe from all of the evils in the world. Douglas would be true to his word for as long as he lived. With the county needing a new ruler, suffered a few years of struggle and turmoil for the citizens. Codnam Castle was destroyed in a mighty battle for the crown, and a new castle was built by the new ruler, Ashbrooking, who was ruled by an evil queen. No delights that much, yet she commanded the county and ruled with an iron fist. Meanwhile, Douglas fled to the Henley-Codnam border, where he had a cottage. Douglas would keep Snow White safe from harm in his cottage, but escape from harm in the battles. Sadly, he was penniless at the king, and as such swallowed his pride and became head gardener of the evil queen. He tended to her garden, trimmed her bush, oh yeah, and destroyed the weeds of Roundup. It wasn't a prettier garden in the kingdom. As nice as he was to the queen, he never trusted her, and as such kept Snow White secret from her. Every day she would venture into the tallest tower, talk to her magic mirror. She would say,
"Mirror, mirror on the wall, who is the fairest of them all?"
And her magic mirror would always reply with,
"You are the fairest of them all, your majesty."
"Good, good. I can't bear to have any of those wretched peasants being prettier than I. If one day some peculiar reason it should happen, I shall rid the kingdom of said person forever." "Who, bless you, horrible Lottie. Never seen an uglier bunch in all my life. There's nothing for it. I shall call the exterminator in." "Unless, of course, you've all paid. Well, have you?"
"Yes."
"Good, good. But did everybody tell you, you have to pay to leave as well?" "What a wicked sense of humour I have. But it's true. You have to pay double to leave." "Minions, attend to me. My name is Queen. You may call me Your Majesty or Queen. My kingdom stretches from Woodbridge to Ashbrooking and is spreading vastly. Henley, unfortunately, is proving harder to take over than I had previously thought. So, I'm recruiting new henchmen to terrorise the neighbours for me." "Well, my bark yourself when you can buy an old dog to do it for you." "Then, this grotty little village will be mine." "Minions, be seated. Of historical nasty men! man. Says here he lived a long time ago, was a ferocious man with an iron heart. He would be perfect! I need another nasty. I'll leave that up to you. Minion, my book.
Ha ha ha!
strange business that, if you ask me.
How do you know?
Well, it's purely by chance. I was working on the rose bushes, which were situated at the bottom of the Eye Tower, when I heard a voice. Yeah, I nearly fell off my foot with fright. Anyway, when I heard it again, I looked round and couldn't see no one. Well, that's when I started to get right freaked out. Then I realised it was a drain pipe. And when I looked up, I saw it was broken by the window of the Eye Tower. So I put my ear to it, and I could hear the Queen and someone else talking. She would say things like, "Who is the fairest of the land?" and the like, and that she would kill anyone who was pretty than her. And when Snow White grew up, I noticed she was getting prettier and prettier by the day. So I thought I'd best keep her even away. I couldn't bear it if Snow White got killed for being prettier than a sunset in summer.
Oh, Douglas, that is terrible.
Did you hear any more, cousin?
Nearer. When did you think I'd abuse my position in that way?
Oh, sorry, Douglas. I just got overexcited.
So did I once. But that's what makes me think something bad is going to happen. That crazy scientist of hers is up to something.
Dr. Frankenstein! I wouldn't worry about him. He struggles to boil water. Let that make it into works. Look, all I was suggesting is that your niece is pretty and deserves to marry a handsome prince and live a fairy tale life.
Well, I quite agree with you. But I can't reveal it to the world whilst the Queen is in power. Oh, I couldn't bear it if anything happened to Snow White.
Did you say Snow White?
Keep your voice down. You never know who might be listening.
You mean your niece is dashing?
Yes, but don't tell no one.
I thought she died when her father was killed.
No, that's what I told the king on his deathbed. The king was so wise, he must have known that something like this was going to happen. He must have foreseen it.
He could have been that wise. He ate poisoned fruit. He didn't foresee that tragedy now, did he?
Well, what was I to do? Snow White must escape and must marry the prince. It was prearranged years ago. But if the queen finds out, they're all be done for.
My cousin's boyfriend, Trevor, works for the prince. I'll send him a message so he can get him to meet him in private. That way, keeps Snow White out of harm's way.
Well, it's a risky plan. What if the queen found out?
She wouldn't. Not if we're careful. Leave it with me. I'll be in contact.
Oh, I'm rather worried. Oh, it's a risky plan. What if the queen finds out? Oh, well, let's keep yourself busy and find some leads. Oh, dear. I can't find no lead around here.
When you want to go out of the house, just like what happened. best at all times. That's why I am the most glamorous out of all of us dwarves.
You are not.
Oh, yes, I am.
Oh, no, you're not.
Oh, yes, I am.
Oh, no, you're not.
Oh, yes, I am.
Oh, no, you're not. John is the most glamorous. You're in second place.
Why do you have to do that? She'll be crying all night.
Okay.
Remember what happened last time?
You mean when she dropped out of the top 20s? FHM sexist females. God, it's not done. She's off at that episode.
Perhaps she should grow up.
Rachel, my sweetie, pay no attention to them. I'll look after you.
Grubs up.
I hate to break it to you, but it's just water.
No, there's other stuff in there.
Why, what?
Rosemary, thyme, basil.
You put basil in the soup?
Poor basil.
You lot are so grateful. I try my best to be a chef, but I can't help if it goes wrong. I am a miner.
You're the same height as one.
So are you.
Look, I can't eat this rubbish. We need to find a cook and a cleaner. Look at the state of this place.
It's all carbon dust gets everywhere, love.
Anyway, we can't afford a cook and a cleaner. Not until we actually find some diamonds in the mine.
If only our singing career had taken off properly, we wouldn't have to become miners. It did take off. We just got ripped off by our music manager. Like most new artists.
And I spent all my money looking glam.
Didn't spend enough, obviously. Hang on, we can make a massive comeback tour. It's been 10 years, then we can make some real money. How about it?
Really? Comebacks are so last year.
Joe's right, we can make our fourth club 71 to get 5 in the top 12.
Look what I've found. Let's give them a go.
Yeah.
think you're another 10 pounds in each buttock? And I'm not talking about money.
You heard the buttock, Arthur. Your bottom rattling like that has sent a tidal wave in Japan.
I don't have a big bottom.
Do I?
Yes, sir.
They are eating them alone. They were chewing out the back there.
Would you like some sweet cinnamon, go lovely? Sorry if I am if you're a kid. Let me see if I get a good throw.
The
vile. However, a new beauty is top of the pile.
It must be broken. I'll try that again. Mirror, mirror on the wall, who is the fairest of them all?
Your Majesty, your mirror does not lie. Your time at the top has now passed by. A new beauty rules the roost. The economy she is sure to boost. For no other girl will shine as bright as the girl with the name Snow White.
This cannot be. No one is more beautiful than me. Minion, my slipper. Stupid mirror. Minion, fetch. I must find this Snow White. Minion, my bell. Because this name so familiar to me, Snow White. Snow White somewhere nearby. Dr. Frankenstein is going to use his smartphone to locate her. I need you to fly over to hers. Use your world-renowned powers of persuasion and bring her here to me. And I will see you.
There she is, lady. And you ain't going to believe it. Her name is Snow White. And she lives on the outskirts of the village, bordering that vile village, Coddenham. And she lives with her uncle, who is your governor. Walking, buying magazines with the pictures of prints in, social media, and staying indoors.
Well, where did you find all this information from?
Well, Facebook and Instagram, of course. I mean, look at her latest status update. Bored again at home, uncle won't let me out, early night it is then, it's not fair. Sad face.
Perfect, I'm struck. I'll fly.
He's certainly over. Oh, Minions, be dismissed and stick this thing with you.
What are you going to do with how much you got, Mum?
Oh, destroy her! Snow White, why is this name so familiar to me? I'm sure it'll come to me, and then she'll...
Why not? Why not?
Go around the island.
Why not? solves everything. Oh, yes you are.
Oh, no, I'm not.
Yes, you are.
I'm just there, sorry, from the kitchen. I was talking to that guy earlier, but I got a chance to do it, so thank you. best date ever. And the best dress.
Thank you, Douglas. You know what? This dress come all the way from America. And it has a guarantee.
What guarantee?
One year to get it off. But anyway, I totally agree. I feel like I'm gonna dance all night. I can dance like that since I was 18. Hitting the clubs and Ipswich. Boom, boom, shake the room.
Oh, you never thought anyone could drink as much and stand, let alone dance.
It takes years of practice, Douglas. Anyway, this perhaps.
Oh, yes, sir. So it is.
I must go in. Good night, Douglas.
Good night, Vera. Oh, did you see that? Oh, God. I'm all of a fluster now. Oh, I think I'll just call myself off for a minute. Did you see that? He kissed me right here. I'm never washing my face again. When was the last time you were kissed? How old were you when you were first kissed, young man? You can tell us, you know, we're all friends here. Your wife won't be upset, I'm sure you. Well, I find it
funny
to be kissed, I don't know about you.
Is it okay, Douglas? I thought I heard you shout.
No, Vera, I just tripped up. That's what happened.
Are you okay, Douglas?
Yes. Thanks, Vera.
Good night, Douglas.
Good night. Oh, God, I nearly got in trouble there, so I really can't be talking about him. Anyway, I need to tell Snow White. Snow White! Oh, I'm so excited! Let me never guess what happened! Oh, where are you? Snow White? Where are you? Oh, no! Oh, she's gone! Oh, Vera! Where are you? I need your help! It's Snow White!
Yes!
Oh,
hello! What's wrong with us?
Oh, it's you, Vera. I didn't realise it was you. I thought you'd been eaten by a curly worry monster.
Dealt with
instant.
For my monster from his slap in her eye, and suddenly, to my surprise, the mash.
He did the monster mash, the monster mash. Oh, it was a great girl's smash. He did the mash. They caught all in a flash. He did the monster mash.
From a laboratory in the castle east.
Bad guy at all.
No,
Not at all. I was providing James with meat. I was doing what he told me to. I never hurt anyone. Well, except for that one time. But that was an accident. One day, James ordered me to take his archer and be out hunting. Shoot him accidentally. I refused. So he beat me, ordered me to go. So I did his bidding. Took his enemy out to the forest and let him go. Unfortunately for me, James had followed us. Killed his enemy and then fired an arrow at me. I retaliated and shot him. Did the whole village a favour. No one ever believed I didn't kill the other guy. Hung me for it and condemned me for all eternity by a silly story which became a legend. I mean, how hard is that? For years people have believed I was a ferocious, nasty man. But I'm not. I'm not a bad guy. I'm not.
I'm a widow. What You will.
her on her.
No joy.
Try your shoe.
What? What? My little vanity pedicure is yours. Try yours.
I bathed mine this morning. Hey, Tina, we need your shoe.
After the intervals.